Well, there's the formal problem of evil, what we call the logical problem of evil, and that is first, I think, stated by Epicurus, but many times since. And the logical problem goes, if God is all good, he would desire to prevent evil, and if he's all powerful, he'd be able to do what he wants. He'd be able to prevent evil, but evil exists. Therefore, God is either not all good or not all powerful, or he doesn't exist. That's the logical problem of evil. I talk about this in my book, but most atheists, I don't know any atheist today, and I don't even know one atheist today that any longer uses the logical problem of evil. They've given it up.
Maybe not any in scholarship.
Well, right. Thank you for that. Good point. That's a very good
Was
point.
gonna say, 'cause down here
Now
on my
you're
level in YouTube land, I hear it all the time,
Oh
so.
yeah, no, you're absolutely now good. Thank you for that clarification. I meant the academic atheist. Village atheists will use it all the time, but the academic atheists, and I quote a lot of them in my book, they've given up the logical problem of evil, largely due to the work of people like Alvin Plantinga, who, because all you have to do is show one possible reason that God might be justified in allowing the evil he allows. And still be good and all powerful. If you can show one possible reason, then the logical problem of evil falls apart. And Plantinga succeeded in that, in showing, here's a possible reason. And like I say, Plantinga even says it may not even be the real reason. It doesn't have to be, because if you can show just even a possible reason as to why God, a good, loving, all powerful God, would have to allow evil, then that the logical problem falls apart. And as I said, academic atheists have given up. They don't even pursue the logical problem of evil. The second way, though, it is still pursued, and it's pursued. The second way it's pursued is the evidential problem of evil, and that is where basically the atheist says, "Okay, yeah, I don't care about the logical problem of evil. I realize that there's a potential out, and that's not going to work. But evidentially speaking, does it make sense that a loving God would allow all the evil that he allows?" And so really, I don't spend a lot of time on the evidential problem in my book because, well, as I mentioned, I quote a number of atheists that go, it doesn't work. The book is basically answering the question of why would God be justified in allowing the evil that he allows?